Vil vi vesen. Ekte lykke.
Vil du beskrive oppveksten din?
Jeg jo vokst opp I et veldig sånn fritt miljø. Fikk en veldig sånn...
It seems like the type to grow up in like that kind of...
Når jeg tok med fantasivenner hjem, for eksempel, så dekte min mor og far på bordet til de.
Fantasy friends? What are fantasy friends?
Jeg sa ikke vil feire bursdagen min. At ok, det greit, og ingen press på å forandre meg hjemmefra. Og ingen sånn behov for å sette noen merkelapper eller diagnoser eller... Men bare helt sånn, helt fritt. Jeg tenkte ikke så mye over hva jeg var og hvorfor jeg følte meg litt annerledes. Jeg tenkte ikke så mye på det. Jeg tenker fortsatt ikke på det. Så det er rart når folk skal begynne å få deg til å tenke over at noe feil.
I think people have a tendency to do that because we have a standard of normal. So... If it's not to that standard, then we begin to say, what's going on here? You know, you're not talking like a normal child, you know? Pretty cute.
Men når var det du skjønte at andre kanskje så deg som litt annerledes?
Jeg tenkte ikke det før sånn I 7. klasse, kanskje. Det var vel et eller annet med at vi tok sånn mensa-test.
Okay.
Og så husker jeg at jeg ble ertet av noen for at jeg fikk
really?
Veldig bra resultat.
Mm.
Og at de sa at det var fordi, og så lo de litt sånn for seg selv. Og så lurte jeg på sånn, hvorfor ler dere av det? Og så lo de fordi at det var jo noe forstod de det, for det var autist.
Så jeg var right.
Jeg var rar
right.
Og...
Rar og smart på sånt.
Ja, men sånn, så det vel første gang noen har på en måte ledd av meg. Ja. Og det som var vondest var at jeg ikke skjønte hvorfor det var morsomt.
Mm. Right.
Jeg skjønte ikke hvorfor de lo. Og så var det veldig ekkelt å merke at de skjønte at jeg ikke skjønte hvorfor de lo.
Ja.
Og så følte jeg meg utenfor.
I say this, my stepsons, they've come a long way. They were diagnosed autistic when they were like 5 or 6. And in the last, 4 years I've known them, they've made such strides to be able to understand how to make a joke, how to laugh, what's funny, you know. So I get where Aurora's talking about. Like, she didn't really understand why they were laughing at her, you know what I mean?
De skjønte at jeg ikke skjønte hvorfor de lo.
Ja.
Og så følte jeg meg veldig utenfor, på en sånn måte at jeg ikke forstod, eller at de antok at jeg ikke forstod. Akkurat som at jeg ikke var I stand til å forstå at
right.
De var frekke.
That the moon over there? Wow! Shout out to that friend who didn't realize he was laughing at a megastar. An autistic girl,
like a
freaking mega star. What are those things called?
Hey, a little spilledås.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, watch them.
Wow. It's been a long time since I've seen one of them things.
Det var en sang som heter Through the Eyes of a Child, som en sang på min første plate fra 2016.
Mm-hmm. Oh, wow.
Hva betyr den låta for deg?
Den betyr ganske mye.
Yeah, it's nice to hear the meaning of that.
Boble, der det eneste jeg så var alt det.
Right.
De vonde tingene.
That's what that song kind of felt like, too.
Mm-hmm. Og så skrev jeg, måtte jeg skrive en sang for å få det ut av systemet.
Yeah, yeah.
Så skrev jeg Through the Eyes of a Child, som handler om å kunne ønske å se verden gjennom et barn sine øyne igjen.
How many of y'all feel like that sometimes? Like seeing the world through the eyes of an adult, you know what I'm saying? It's depressing sometimes, you know? But sometimes it can be beautiful, but seeing the world through the eyes of a child once again, like you remember how you felt when you was a kid, just so carefree, unattached, you know? But then as you grew up, deficits started happening, experiencing, and now that light you had kind of dims up a little bit, you know?
Det som skal skje nå, det har å gjøre på en måte med litt ditt barnslige jeg. Nå skal jeg ta deg med til et sted hvor du kan lage din egen fantasiverden.
This is pretty cool.
Så bli min.
Look at her face light up.
Hallo, hallo.
Hei.
Jeg tenkte at vi skulle gå opp på toppen av Media City og prøve noen greier.
Ja.
Det bare å følge etter meg.
Hvis det sånn spill rett på øynene, det får jeg migreneanfall av.
Gjør du?
Det de jeg får migrene ut av.
Yeah. Det briller?
Ja.
Gjør du det?
Ja.
She gets migraines from... She gets migraines.
Ok, men da må vi droppe det, altså.
Nei.
Nei, men du...
Nei!
Men du...
Får jeg ikke lage din fantasiverden, da? Jeg elsker jo... Spill og sånne ting.
Ja, ja, ja.
Det er kjempegøy, så det her er jo min drøm.
Det sucks.
Kanskje vi bare
gjør det? Det vi hadde først tenkt å gjøre var berg- og dalbane, men det tror jeg blir litt ekstremt.
Jeg vil ikke gå glipp av et helt et liv uten dette.
She's able to still overcome.
Jeg har andre smertestillende, så de funker kjempebra på meg.
Kan du merke at du blir svimmel, og så kan du slutte?
Ja, jeg merker det litt. Jeg kan merke det på forhånd.
So she still has the courage to do it, even though she can't.
Altså,
that's cool.
Jeg bare tar en part
til det. Ikke føler at du må gjøre det.
Nei, jeg har veldig lyst til å ta begge damer.
Jeg veldig opptatt av å si sånn at du må ikke
føle
at du blir tvunget.
I wonder how she would do on the Gravitron, y'all.
Det her en sånn jungelberg-dame.
Er det sant? Oh my god, det er kjempegøy. Kjempegøy! Får dere sug også? Eller er det bare en?
Vi får ikke så mye sug.
Men hvis jeg spyr, kan du spy der?
Ja, da henter vi en bøtte.
Jeg er litt svimmel, og jeg blir litt kvalm, men det går fint. Jeg gikk ned den bakken. Shit.
That was the cutest little cuss word I ever heard.
Nei, jeg må ikke stoppe her.
Kan du fremme?
Oh my god.
Hvordan går det?
Det var kjempegøy.
Og nå det tid for at du skal...
Wow, she's so brave. That's cool.
Okay.
Bare begynne å tegne i 3D.
I'm really proud of her. This the perfect song for this part. This the perfect song for this part.
Feathers falling out of a pillow, as if time is standing.
Need more pink.
I can't remember much more, but I know.
Hi, Bubbles.
Hey, can't you have a fantasy world without butter?
Ja, det må være overalt. Dette her det beste. Oi, jeg glemte at dere var her.
Bubbles make you forget about everything, don't it?
Jeg fikk ikke vondt å hore da.
Gjorde du ikke?
Nei.
Wow.
Det er gøy å gå inn i det.
Ja. Alle boblene og sånn gjør det jo liksom litt koselig. Nå tenker jeg å ta deg med videre. Fra en verden til en helt annen.
Nå?
Ja.
That's really cool that she didn't let that fear stop her from experiencing that, even though she knew she was going to get sick. I bet it's one of those galaxy lights. Oh, that's a clue to where they're going.
Indian skog. Det føles min favoritt type skog som er barnåler på bakken.
Baby needles on the ground. Talk about grass. Or pine needles. Jeg er glad
på hennes egne. Hun som kan være inne der. Og det kan være hun synger, det kan være hun danser. Sannsynligvis nok begge deler.
Her imagination is wild, bro. Her imagination is crazy. You can tell how she like really focuses in and she starts to create this whole world for that little person by asking those questions. I'm kind of the same way too. Like sometimes when I look at stuff or old buildings or old houses, like I like to see like what would that building, like I try to imagine what that building would look like maybe 50, 60 years ago. Like was it a lively building? Was it a club? You know what I'm saying? Who were the type of people coming into this building? You know, it's kind of weird.
Oj, fordi hun synger med hele seg, liksom. Det kommer ut, og det ja, det sånn opplevelse du ikke kan beskrive.
Okay, we got the whole brigade coming.
Fordi at hennes sanger veldig sterke, og det har mye power i seg.
Det et utløp for mange følelser. I en hverdag som kanskje ganske hektisk, så det godt å finne fram til den frustrasjonen.
Super Mario and Luigi's little brother right here.
Musikken til Aurora.
Og det at personligheten hennes bare kjenner igjennom, det veldig kult.
There's many different types of people that live there. I didn't expect to see so many different nationalities. She's smelling weed. No, I'm kidding. No, I'm kidding.
Her har vært mye i min barndom. Jeg måtte noe om vi skulle inn her. Nei. Skal vi inn her?
Nice.
Yes. Dude, I would love to go out there. Yeah, feel the grass beneath my feet. Hopefully it ain't no snakes out there, you know what I'm saying? I would love to travel the world and see different landscapes, man. I just wish I had the money to do that kind of thing. Like, yeah, the trees are awesome. I bet those light up. It's easy to get lost in this documentary. It almost makes you feel like you're watching a movie. This ain't even I couldn't even classify this as a documentary, mostly. Oh, this is the river performance. I know somebody wanted me to react to this.
Yeah.
I like the breakdown of that. I like the way kind of the tempo went up and down right there. Let me go back. See? Oh, that's the girl from the... See? That's a bridge. I love the way she uses her lyrics too, man. Such imagery in those lyrics. I like the way she does. Think about what she said. I'm a shadow. I am cold and I see for warmth. That's so poetic, bro. But the way she delivered it with such passion. Do I want to say passion? There's probably another word I want to say. With such, you know, kind of had that breathy. But now I seek for. Like that. I can't sing, y'all. Ooh, okay, the support vocals are there. That's... can cry drinking your eyes, but I like the ending of that last one where it says like a bird at night, let your emotions be free. I had a hard time contrasting like a bird at night because most birds are sleeping. Are we see that's how my mind works. I'll be trying to analyze the lyric. Did that make sense? You know what I'm saying? But okay, I'll let it rock. Man, you know, to sing a song like that in the forest makes that, brings the atmosphere of that song to life. Because the way I imagine the song, and if it's being sung in the forest, just imagine like it's the, how you soaking that in, right? You in the forest, you looking up at the sky, it's blue, it's kind of gloomy up there, and then you see in the forest around you, you're hearing the reverbs and the echoes and a voice and stuff, and it sounds like that song may just keep you trapped, like you want to stay in that bubble forever, you know? So where the ocean is bigger, you can become part of the river. Let your emotions be free. Now I kind of understand that, to let your emotions be free like a bird, line with the, including it with the hook, you know what I'm saying? Then the oceans turning into rivers. I get that now. I get that. It's kind of all about expressing your emotions and not holding back. If you need to cry, go ahead. like this song. Y'all gotta give me the links to the videos. Amazing how a voice can touch people that's
velkommen hit I skogen til konsert med hun deres
older than her.
Aurora. Foran deg står foreldrene dine, bandet ditt og fansene.
Who are her parents?
Hva tenker du?
Hallo. Oi. Hei, så rart. Tror du ikke vi skulle hit? Hvor lenge har dere stått her? Så fint. Hei. Hei. Det var veldig magisk.
Dere, vi her for å feire Aurora, og I løpet av dagen så har vi blitt ganske godt kjent, og hun har fortalt meg mange ganger I dag at hun har et større prosjekt med musikken enn bare musikken. Hun vil jo bruke musikken til at vi alle skal få det bedre. Og Mari, hvordan har du det akkurat nå?
Jeg føler veldig mye. Jeg føler så mye akkurat nå, og det... Det sprenger inni meg, egentlig. Så veldig magisk.
Nå skal vi straks til en låt som betyr mye for deg.
Ja, Infections of a Different Kind. Og når jeg hørte den første gang, så var det bare som et veldig stort speil for at jeg fikk lov til å slippe alt fri. Og at jeg kjente at, å ja, det bare jeg som kan slippe det fri, og jeg får lov.
Men du, Silje, du ikke helt fremmed for denne sangen der du heller.
Nei, det ikke.
Fortell.
Når du da kom ut med albumet ditt, hørte gjennom hele albumet, det ga meg så mye håp og så mye, ja, bare en motivasjon til å gå videre, at dette klarer, og at nok.
How do American artists get this kind of thing that happens to them? Like, you know, sometimes we have to really cross-analyze how other countries do things with their artists versus what we do in America. And sometimes our artists don't really get an opportunity to have this personal connection with their fans like this. It's always a book signing, a photo shoot, a new music video, back in the studio, back on tour. And then sometimes you become so out of touch with your fans, you don't really know what's going on. And I'm guessing with a show like this, or just with this type of documentary, like she's really feeling her fans' experiences with her music. And I think that's important for the artist to understand, like how your music is affecting other people. In America, you don't get that kind of thing. I think American artists just get so detached, you know, with their busy schedules. But let's go.
Til å gå videre, at dette klarer, og at nok,
you can tell she's really focused and listening to her too.
Så det har tatt med meg langer ut I livet.
Takk. Dere så snille. Dere så gode. Jeg tror virkelig at det så mye håp for oss mennesker for å klare det vi vil. Og for å gjøre ting som mye, mye, mye større enn oss selv.
I wonder what happened if I would scratch that tree. Infections of a different kind.
The world is a hole, we all seem to fall. And
song is so quiet.
And the universe is growing tall. And we are caving into dreams of this space. Unfolding our arms cannot.
Here, look at everybody about to cry.
Violent control.
Would we even know his name? What's really the driving force behind this song right here? Is it the piano? It feels like a ballad. And you think about it, like with the melody kind of carrying it, she's able to put space. She's able to put some kind of space in between the vocals that kind of makes you ponder on what she just said sometimes. I'm gonna take it back a few notches. So right after violent contractions, and then watch how there's space in between each bar, and then find yourself like really like pondering, because that's what I was doing. It's really a song that invokes thought, really. His name is Yahweh. Yahuwah. He has. He definitely has. Like, man, look at them. He has turned away. Boy, she is in the moment right there. See how she hey, sometimes you just gotta be present. Look how present she just soak me with your beautiful voice. This is crazy. I just wanna watch that one more time. Homegirl will say, her imagination took her somewhere else. Infections of a different kind. The world has been attacked by our pain. If I am the world, then why would I hurt all that is living? And if there is. That's an interesting delivery. I'm sorry I'm pausing so much, but that's an interesting delivery. That she went to a low tone with that. Interesting choice of words. I knew she was crying. She seems like she's really absorbing the emotions of the crowd in real time. And you look at her, I like to look at her expressions a lot, but you can really see like she's really soaking in that moment. Is she making eye contact with people? See that right there? You looking at her. such a soft song, like. I would really love to learn how each instrument communicates. You know, I don't know how to research that kind of thing, but I would just love to know how each instrument communicates, like what signals is like each instrument, the purpose of each instrument, like what's the purpose of a piano, like what does that do for music, and how is built, you know what I'm saying, to make people feel, or like what's the purpose of these instruments that we use, not just, you know, mastering the instrument but communicating through that instrument. Like, it just, I'm sorry. Look like she about to cry herself.
Hvordan har du det med å være her I dag?
Det litt uvirkelig, men veldig fint.
Hva forholdet ditt til Aurora?
For et par år siden så møtte jeg veggen. Og det var veldig tungt. Og så hørte jeg på radioen en som het Aurora. Jeg visste ikke hvem det var. Som spilte Runaway. Og når jeg hørte den teksten, når du synger Take me back home, I can't take this anymore. Det hjalp meg veldig. Det ble veldig sterkt. Og veldig trist og fint samtidig. Og det ble en påminnelse om å ta tak I sitt eget liv igjen da.
Mm-hmm.
Så den hører jeg på enda som en sånn konstant påminnelse om at man kan alltid komme hjem, og det fint.
So we gonna do Runaway in the Forest? That's actually kind of synonymous, actually. This is the second time I've reacted to this song. So let's see if it's like any type of different delivery she does.
But when I picked it up, then it vanished away from my hand. I had a dream I was seven, climbing away in a tree. I saw a piece of heaven waiting in patience for me.
Saw a piece of heaven waiting patient for me. That's her parents. I can't take it anymore. How does that feel as parents to create such a being like Aurora? Like, how does that feel, you know? I was painting a, I like this song. So what we, around 20 reactions, I think Runaway's in my top five. She know all the words. Handle that mixing board. Oh, is this a change-up? I don't remember this from the first one. Well, it's been like 2 months. I have no new perspectives on this song. I just like to see everybody in the crowd like really enjoying themselves. That's really cool. Nice. Does she ever explain why she does this? Like shakes her head? He does that when she's like transitioning her songs too.
Skrev jeg for ganske lenge siden. Den ganske trist.
That's the girl that she was playing that really in. Oh no, that's I forgot her name, y'all. Been quiet. I can't believe she did this. Now, before she starts, I remember somebody in the comic section. I can't remember who or what their name was, but they said the first few lyrics reminded it rains against her will. Like they quoted like a part of the song like that was right at the start. And they said they kind of screamed to him like there was like a getting somebody getting RP'd. So, how do y'all feel like when you listen to this song over and over? I think it's just the figurative language though. Like you could take that line as like a pillow fight in a way. That's a, that breathy delivery works with that word so well. Just caught that. I didn't catch it in my first reaction. I just caught that when I put those two images together, blood on the earth, flower falling out of the window, flower deep. Yeah. Deflowered. Yep. It is. It's probably about what people think it is then. Just beautiful vocals, man. And her backup vocalist is crazy, too. Did that just bring that song full circle? In the last verse, she said, "Is the earth colored red as flowers fall out of your window?" Then in this one, she said, "And I bleed in your bed, turn it red like a ground outside of your window." So did something happen outside and inside the house too? I like that view. It's like she's looking at her matching her at the same time. Wow. I wonder why she played that song there. Because nobody suggested that song, so I wonder why she played it there.
Anette, hva gir Aurora og musikken hennes deg?
Musikken din på en måte en slags lomme I tiden, føler jeg. Som man bare kan skli inn I, hvis man trenger det. Hvis man trenger å bare sette alt litt på pause, og bare være I den verden som man på en måte har inne I hodet sitt, I stedet for den som utenfor. Og det tror jeg mange trenger en gang iblant. Så takk for det.
Takk. Det betyr kjempemye at dere lar musikken slippe inn.
Let me elaborate on that statement. He says it's really good that you let the music in. Music is the only thing on this planet that can bypass your frontal lobe. So think about it like this. If you can think about a song that you hate, but you know the words to, that's what I'm talking about. Music and the reason why, I think that's the reason why it's done in such a, in a mind control kind of fashion with music in America is simply because it has it deals with frequency. You can't really lock frequency. So you can't really shut out frequency in your brain. So music is the only thing that can bypass this defense. This is where we make all our decisions, our discernment, and you have no defense against music. That's what I learned through listening to so much music. That's why sometimes you got to be very careful about what you entertain, because it can still affect you. You know, so sometimes even with Aurora, I have to take some time off from reacting to her music, because like I kind of understand, you know what I'm saying? Like, I don't want her music to, I like her music, but I also don't want her music to govern my decisions. You know what I'm saying? That might be looking at it a little bit too deep. If y'all don't understand, where's that book at? I can't find it. I thought it was up there. But I was going to show you this book. It shows what I'm talking about, but let's go.
Ja, tack.
Och Aurora, du tror ju att överraskelsen är färdig nu.
Nej, gör mig.
Alltså jag har ju självklart en överraskelse på konserten också. Jag har inte tänkt att säga mer än det. Jag säger bara vi gläder oss.
I want to climb that tree, bro. I like this song. It's one of my top five. I love how she uses her words and the imagery that you get from just listening to this. What's happening here? It's amazing how she can keep her composure, still sing and deliver the song while this big old surprise is happening around her, right? I like this. I actually like this. There's a couple baritone guys I'm hearing. It sounds so tribal, you know what I'm saying? I eat money. Hey. Look how she's taking that energy from those men. Those guys singing is making us sing more aggressive.
Thank you.
I just, that's such a hype bridge right there. Even she feel it. Boy smiling, you ain't see that? He liked that. Homeboy liked that. Dexter. Hey, what's up, Dexter? My boy Dexter loves it.
Mannsko er det vakreste. Jeg vet. Det er ikke deilig å synge en sånn aggressiv låt sammen.
Yeah, I see.
Jeg synes det var helt nydelig.
Oh. Yeah. That was cool. I like that. What's this song? Sound like it's more a beat. Bro. All this soft inside. This is probably one I haven't heard yet. There we go. I kind of knew it was going to pick up right there. Hold up. I want to take that back to the beginning. That was kind of weird. I don't know what sound that is, but it sounds like glass clicking together. Do 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 do. Is what sound? What instrument is that? I knew just by that it was gonna be upbeat. Thing I want to say, I like how slow and melodic this performance or this concert started, right? So we started with things that's like very emotional. So now everybody's tuned in. Now we can pick up the pace. So I like the choices in songs because you did the seed last and that kind of builds the song back up. So now it's like every other song was like breaking everybody down emotionally. And now it's like, okay, so let's give y'all some good emotions before we end this thing, you know? Like she changes into a completely different person. She's so like strong and confident when she's singing, but then when she turns, I feel like I've heard this before. Thank you. Isn't that the lady that sung to her? Isn't that the lady that sung to her? I think so. She has such charisma. And shoot, let's not compliment the endurance on her vocals, man. She's done about 8-7 songs now. And her breath, her breathing is just the same. Her delivery just the same. I want to be more expressive like that, using my hands and my body and stuff. I like that. It exudes more energy, you know what I'm saying? Like when I'm talking to y'all. Slight sound right there. Like, what's that sound? I like that. Oh, they use real instruments for this. This is not synthesized right here. They had somebody play this in the studio. Ain't no way you can get this through pre-made sounds. Oh, I like that. Hey. See how uplifting this song is now? Is that those things? What are those? A xylophone? Is that a xylophone? Yeah, that could be a xylophone. I like this song. How did they put on their shirts that fast?
Nå nærmer det seg slutten, og hvordan var det her?
Det har vært helt fantastisk. Men sånn virkelig takk for at dere hører på. Det gjør med sånn respekt og sånn åpenhet. Det er da musikken blir skikkelig vakker når noen tar den inn. Det er da han blir skikkelig fin, synes jeg. Det er da jeg skjønner hvor vakker musikk er.
Yeah, music is a beautiful thing.
Når jeg lager musikk, så er jeg lykkelig. Så kjenner jeg hvorfor jeg er her.
She gets a sense of purpose from it.
Sånn, som nå, så skjønner jeg hvor fint musikk er.
Right, right.
Så takk for alt. Virkelig.
Had to swallow that yawn right there. J5, speak ikke, to me.
Ikke glem å drømme stort.
Hey man, what are subtitles? Don't be.
Silly can
watching storms, sitting quiet, reading books in the heat of city lights.
I got an image for every one of those words. Daydreamer. Look how everybody feeling it, man. Okay, a little change up right there. Okay, got that tribal drum right there. Yeah. See one of them break out in a twerk. That'll make my day. This song is pretty straightforward though. I can see they using that African drum right there. Those instruments right there, I know for a fact they had somebody play them live in the studio. That right there, that sound live. Who threw the feathers? Having too much fun. Oh, she did the Xena cry. It's funny, like me and the crowd are having the exact same emotions. Good job, Aurora. After every song, they seem to go to her parents and show them. That was good. This was good. I really like this. What were the other two documentaries y'all wanted me to check out? Wow, they went all out for her. That was cool. I like this. All right, guys. That was quite an experience to see that for the last 40 or so minutes. That was quite an experience right there. I don't know what else to say. But let me know the other two documentaries y'all want me to check out. Full live performances. I know the Nidaros Domen, y'all wanted to do a live or get that full reaction, just post those links in the description box, man. I'm gonna keep you guys long, but if you guys appreciate the reaction, hit your brother with a like if you're still here. Royal fans, Warriors and Riddles, thank you. I see y'all at the next one, all right?